I always ask myself, what's the point where a craft becomes an art? And I don't know where it is. Because I think a craft is an art. The only difference is that it's executed by popular hands. And that's where the difference is. Well, my name is Marcello Bavaro. My company is Quebracho. Quebracho is the name of the strongest tree in the world, and it's native to the place where I come from, which is Argentina. The poetry behind the name is being the strongest wood in the world will give me good roots for me to grow a company. We are frame makers. There are many ways that you could see a frame without thinking that it's a frame. The hair on people is the frame of a face, which makes me hairless, frameless. The other thing that a frame does is that complements a piece of art. And it creates a halo, almost a holy piece. That's why gold was so important to begin with, just because of the reflection that it creates, and it's a pure form of light around a painting. So we have people from Colombia, from Ecuador, from Mexico. We don't have anything. They are part of this. We're a family. We work together, we live together, we take care of each other. Just craftsmanship alone is not enough. You have to take it to an art level. If he's a historical artist, you have paths in books and things that tells you how to approach that particular artist, and always manipulating the things that you have already seen in his work and make it work for this particular piece of art. This is a 16th century frame, actually. It housed a Van Dyck at one point or another. Building a frame like this, it would take us about 6-8 months. They would just carve all around this particular, you could see it from here, which is carved all around, and then nail it down onto the frame, and the same thing they would do with the lip and the back of it. We are losing this craft. People expect things to be done overnight. This cannot be done overnight. We're gonna end up having frames that are done by machines. We're trying to survive as long as possible. When a frame grows old with a painting, it's almost a marriage that is almost impossible to separate from each other. They grow old together. They age together. They patina together. They have a relationship that is very difficult to pull apart. Ornaments are produced by the hands of the people of the places where they come from. Their beliefs, their superstitions, what they are afraid of, it's all immersed in there. It's all in there. All those little minute things, when you put it together, it reflects the people that made that frame. You have to respect two things: the period that you're painting and the painter that you're framing for. That we know that if we ask Picasso, would you like this frame, he would agree.